Test, test, test. Chat. Good morning and welcome to PNW Athletics Today. I am Rick Costello, Director of Athletics and the host for the show. We got an outstanding show ahead featuring our student athletes from our men's soccer and esports program, and the coaches of those programs are going to join us as well. Joining us here for the opening segment is Coach Luke Dunn, men's soccer head coach in your first year. How are you doing, Coach?
Good. How are you doing this morning?
I am doing great. Thanks for joining us. We're going to go with our Inside the Pride segment, and then we're going to bring in our special guests.
All right.
Good. So PNW Athletics is 20 sports, 450 student athletes, and we are in our seventh year of NCAA Division II action. The PNW Pride have been giving back to the local community. Assistant AD Natalie Jarrett has been leading our students into the Hammond schools to work with second graders on reading and writing. So anytime that we have our student athletes giving back to the community, it's an awesome thing.
Yeah, it is. Always good to be out there.
We also were involved in a trunk or treat a few weeks ago for Halloween and had a whole bunch of youngsters come on campus, and the Pride were giving them candy and talking to them all about PNW.
Yeah, nothing says athletics like free candy.
There we go. We are also involved with Special Olympics, American Heart Association, Northwest Indiana Food Bank. So it's amazing all the things that our student athletes are doing in the community. It's a busy time of the year. Davenport just came in and played us in volleyball. And our women's volleyball took them out, first time ever. They are on the road this weekend at Grand Valley and Saginaw Valley. And they have had a historic season. So we're hoping that Coach Douglas and his team pull off a couple dubs.
Yes, absolutely.
Cross country, Christina Shaganall set her personal record for the Pride at Purdue Northwest, a 6K. She came in at 21:45. That'd be no problem for you, right, Coach?
Sure.
Now that is picking them up and putting them down. So congrats to Christina Shaganaw. Quinton Bach led our men's cross-country program in the Midwest regionals as well. Ice hockey's off to a great start. Our ice hockey program is ranked 20th in the nation. Our Division II ice hockey program is at 7-5 right now, having a really good season. Esports, so we'll hear from those student-athletes and coaches a little bit later in the broadcast, and they just won the battle for Indiana, taking down Ball State, Purdue University, and IU. So congrats to Coach Bragg and his squad. Men's soccer, wow, congratulations, Coach. Big semifinal win on Sunday. You got to be pumped up.
Yeah. It was a great performance from the team, really good win, and looking for more of the same this Sunday in the finals.
So Sunday, 1 o'clock, we see our graphic on the screen there. 1 o'clock at Dowling Park, take on Saginaw Valley for an automatic qualifier, a GLIAC championship, automatic qualifier to the NCAA. You got to be elated.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Very excited for the team. Proud of what the guys have done and really looking forward to see what we can still do this year.
All right. We're going to catch up with a couple of your student athletes in a second here. Division II ice hockey has Adrian at home this Sunday. D1 ice hockey has Grand Valley coming in this Sunday. Women's basketball gets started with their tip-off. They play Hillsdale and Tiffin Friday and Saturday at the Fitness and Recreation Center. Men's basketball starts the season in Kansas City this weekend. They take on Rockhurst and William Jewell. And Esports has the United Gaming Fan Fest at Westville. Coach, we just heard about your video background, a little bit video gaming background. So maybe jump over there and
might have to
check,
go check
out
it
some
out.
Of the action. All right. So we got a big weekend of a lot of action for the pride of Purdue Northwest. Let's talk to our special guests here. We got Ryan Moran from Australia.
Morning,
Jacob Batista, also from Australia. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Thanks for joining us.
My pleasure. Good to be here.
You got to be pumped up for the big game on Sunday.
Yeah, very pumped up. It's going to be my first final. So, yeah, we've got a lot to prove.
Yep.
Ryan, you've been around for a while.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to be just absolutely excited about this.
For sure. It's so good to... So when I came in like 3 years ago, we weren't even really like this. We weren't ever close to being where we are now. So to do it in a season with Coach Luke is crazy. So I'm really looking forward to Sunday. I'm sure we can pull it off.
All right. Love that confidence. Coach Dunn, you're in your first year leading the Pride of Purdue Northwest. You were an assistant coach here for Ryan Hayes. You went to Viterbo and just had remarkable success here. This has been a historic season for our men's soccer program. Two players of the year, Hugo Lorenzo, offense, Eli Williams, goaltender, second place finish, and now hosting a GLIAC championship game.
Yeah, it's been a crazy season and, you know, in some ways, maybe something we expected, but a little bit unexpected in some ways as well. So we're excited of what the team has done and excited to see where it can go, even still this season. So.
Ryan, you are from Perth, Australia, a senior marketing major, honorable mention this year, a GLIAC player, had the winning goal in this semifinal game. Give me your thoughts on that semifinal victory and taking on Saginaw Valley in the championship.
It was good. Sunday was good against Davenport. That was my first goal this season, so it was about time I'd finally done something. Jacob and Hugo had been carrying us all year, so on the goal side, sorry. But, that was really good, and we're probably looking forward to a similar result on Sunday if possible, but... Yeah, we're all feeling good. It's really good to finally be in a final for once. A lot of us probably haven't even been in a final or won anything at all. So it's good to finally be able to get something at the end of playing so many years of the same sport and not really winning anything, whether that be here or not. But yeah, no, it's really good to have something to look forward to Sunday. So.
Excellent. Jacob Batista also joins us here. You are from Melbourne, Australia, a senior marketing major as well. You were a transfer. You came with Coach Luke from Viterbo. You were on the second team this year. And according to our stats guy, you're second in the league in goals and assists. So you've had an excellent season. One goal and three assists in the semifinals. Tell me about that semifinal win and taking on Saginaw Valley in the championship game.
Yeah, well, the last 3 years of the Turbo, we've always gone out in the semifinals, so I didn't want Houston to repeat itself. Hugo's had an amazing year, so I thought it was time for me to step up now. I was a bit upset with only getting second team, to be honest, and having one to prove.
All right, so, we got a little... I couldn't agree with you about that performance. The AD loved it because you got two quick goals, two more in that after the half, and my blood pressure was low. I was enjoying it.
It eases the nerves.
Yes, it does. That was great. So that's a good script. If we could do that again Sunday, I'd really like that.
We'll work on it.
All right. Even better. So I don't know if we're having some technical difficulties here, but we're going to roll on here, gentlemen.
All right.
So, guys, tell us how you got started in soccer. Ryan, how'd you get started in soccer?
I can't really remember that far back. Probably the earliest thing I remember was playing like year one, year two, and going just beyond like tapping the ball to each other and actually playing a little bit competitive. That's kind of the only thing I really remember. I think it's always been a part of my life, so I can't go back to pinpoint a particular part of my life where it started.
So it's always been a part of your life. What do you love so much about it?
As I was saying, like, we haven't won in ages, or no one's won an actual tournament. Very rare to win something, and it's crazy that you don't get any reward, but you still play for that many years of your life without winning anything. So anything that does that is probably a pretty powerful thing. So,
Jacob, how did you get started in soccer?
Well, I've been playing since the age of three. For me, soccer is heavily connected with my ethnicity, being Greek and Italian background. My parents, they go to church, and you know, as a three-year-old going to Greek school in a church, you don't really understand what's going on. So you want to be outside playing football with the rest of the kids.
Yeah.
And that's where it sort of stems from. And then you grow up with that sort of culture and you want to get into it. You play with your cousins, you play with your friends. There's not too many kids in Melbourne to play. So I tried Australian football for a bit. I was actually better at it than soccer, but yeah, I felt more accepted playing soccer than Australian football, so I kept on with that route, and I'm glad I did, because I'm right here right now on Jet TV.
Excellent. Jet TV is being streamed worldwide. A little shout out there. I love it. So, guys, we're going to get to know you a little bit better with our rapid-fire component, always my favorite. Jacob, you're up to bat first here. Favorite ice cream?
Cookies and cream.
Okay. Favorite food?
Chinese food.
Okay. What's your favorite movie?
I can't say that. That's going to swear. Favorite movie? The Incredibles.
Okay. And where are you at on social media?
I just got Instagram and Snapchat. So I got Facebook, but I just...
I haven't used it
to remind me of people's birthdays.
Yeah, same.
Ryan, favorite ice cream?
I'd probably say I'm more of a chocolate chip cookie dough type of guy.
Chocolate chip cookie dough, all right. Yeah. Favorite food?
Probably Italian or something. That's probably a very generic answer, but I'll go with Italian.
All right. Favorite movie?
I'd probably say Catch Me If You Can. It's got Leonardo DiCaprio in it.
There you go. All right. And where are you at on social media?
Same, like Instagram, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat probably.
I'm surprised to see Facebook from this demographic.
No, I know.
We just have it for the birthdays, I think. Yeah. just to know what's happening.
All right, we're going to do a little competition, see how well you guys know Coach Luke. All right, so what do you think his favorite ice cream is, gentlemen? Jacob, what do you think?
Is it like mint or something like that?
Ryan?
I remember getting this question last year, and I got it right, so if I get it wrong, the pressure's on here. I'm thinking you're a chocolate chip cookie dough type.
Yes. All right, Ryan's got one.
That's two for two.
All right, there you go. His favorite food. Jacob?
Italian. I'd probably say Italian too, but I'm guessing it's not. I'm just going to go with Italian just in case.
Mexican food.
All right.
Should have known.
Okay, his favorite movie. There you go. That's a tough one, Jacob.
Oh, this is embarrassing. Give us a clue.
Now, come on, this is a competition. There's sorry, no help here.
Favorite movie? The Princess Diaries.
Second favorite.
Princess Diaries 2. I'm joking.
All right, where do you think he's at on social media?
Definitely Facebook guy. He sends us a lot of TikToks as well.
TikTok, coach.
Yeah, there's some good videos out there. Probably Twitter.
All right. I don't know. I think that was just an abysmal performance. But we'll give Ryan a win on that one. All right, coach, what do these gentlemen mean to your program?
Both have been great this season. Jacob coming in, helping the team score goals. That's always an important part of the game. He's done a great job there. Ryan is kind of taking on a new role this year, going from being a forward the last couple of seasons with the team and now deeper into the midfield. So statistically, he's not doing as much this year, but I think if you look at his performance on the field and what he means to the team, it's probably more impactful than he's been. So two of the guys that have been leading the team really from the first day, first game, and have continued to do so, came up big in the semifinal, and I'm sure they're going to do just as well in the finals.
Great. All right, we got two marketing majors. We've been blasting this game out on social media. We got to post it all over the university, emails, all that kind of stuff. All right, so now I'm going to each give you 10 seconds to give your pitch to our listening audience why they should show up 1 o'clock Sunday, GLIAC Championship for the Purdue Northwest Pride.
Is it going to be a half-half thing or is it a 1-1?
You can each have 10 seconds. How about that?
You go on, Jacob.
We're not about to start yet.
We're not very good at marketing, are we?
It's hard to point out like a marketing strategy.
You want to do a strategic plan first?
Yeah, exactly. This is straight off the dome.
If you've got nothing else better to use your time, please come down to Darling Park, 1 p.m. Sunday. I know where you live, so please come.
Ryan.
What he said. We know where you all live, so hopefully we'll see you down on Sunday to add to the atmosphere. We'll see you there.
All right. Wonderful. Well, I wish you guys nothing but the best of luck. I can't wait for the game, and it's going to be exciting for sure. So,
yes, it will be.
Good luck, and we will see you all on Sunday.
See you there.
Thank you. Right. See you there.
We're going to take a quick break and have our next guest, Esports.
Bank of Hammond building in the 5400 block of Calumet Avenue. It has vaulted ceilings and was designed by the same architect who did Comiskey Park. Councilman Dave Warpool toured the facility and said it would make a nice store or restaurant. The former Brum's Bloomin' Barn is moving to St. John. David Gerlach bought one of the region's oldest gift shops in 2020 from the Brum family. He said his lease hasn't been renewed and that he'll move south down US 41 in January and rebrand as BLVD by Bloomin' Barn. 45th Street Partners LLC bought the shopping center where Brum's Bloomin' Barn was and invested $325,000 in renovations. Bloomin' Barn manager Aaron Schloss says that the developer plans to divide the Brum's storefront into two separate spaces to lease out. And in sports, This weekend, we will have plenty of action from both PNW and CCSJ for your viewing pleasure. Friday at 7, the PNW women's basketball team will take on Hillsdale College in the GLIAC GLVC crossover, and on Saturday at 3, the Pride face Tiffin. The CCSJ men's basketball team will meet Michigan Dearborn at 2:30. At 11 a.m., you can catch the Crimson Wave Sprint football team take on Bellarmine. On Sunday, the PNW hockey team will be in action at 5 and 8 p.m. And last but certainly not least, the Pride's men's soccer team battles Saginaw Valley State at 1 p.m. for the GLIAC Championship. You can catch all of that right here on Jet TV. To read more on these stories, head to NWI.com. I'm Sonny Santana, and this was your 219 News Now.
Welcome back to PNW Athletics Today. I am Rick Costello, Director of Athletics and the host for the show. I am joined in studio by Coach Justin Bragg, Ryan Soja, and Felix Barrera of our eSports program. How are you gentlemen doing?
Great.
Doing great. Warm morning.
All right.
Better than recently.
Thanks for joining us. Coach Bragg, you're in your fourth year as the head coach of the eSports program. You were a top League of Legends player during your playing days. You've done an amazing job building the program. We're up over 150 students. 66 games just took place. How'd our squad do?
Yeah, we made it out of groups. So there were 16 teams there. So top two teams of each group advance. We were the 10 seed, so we ended up beating the 7 seed twice to advance to the group of 8. And then we ended up losing to the top seed Winthrop, who ended up winning it all.
And then major congrats, a battle for Indiana Championship and League of Legends, taking down Ball State, Purdue University, and IU. Congratulations.
Appreciate it. Yeah, it's our second time in 3 years, so we're really happy with that result.
That's fantastic. And we've got the NACE playoffs going on. Our League of Legends team won the other night against Oklahoma Christian. You want to tell us about the NACE playoffs?
Yeah, so NACE is really an organizing body for collegiate esports. They run a lot of tournaments, so all of our titles are competing in it. League of Legends, Valorant, and Call of Duty all made the national playoffs for that. And League of Legends, it's the top 8. So that first round was played last night, or 2 nights ago now. And League of Legends beat Oklahoma Christian 2-0, so now it's the national semifinals versus Maryville, which is one of the best teams in the nation.
And then we have a big event coming up this weekend, Saturday and Sunday on our Westville campus, the Unified Gaming Fan Fest returns.
Yeah, so we did this event last year in March, and it was a great success. It's part of our League of Legends season during the spring. And then during the fall is Valorant and Super Smash Brothers. So this will be a very similar event to what we did last year, and with the only exception being the stage was League of Legends last year. The stage will now be Valorant for this upcoming weekend.
All right, let's meet our special guests. We have Felix Barrera of Munster, Indiana, a senior accounting major. Felix has been part of the program all 4 years. League of Legends player on the team with both the Battle for Indiana wins 3 years ago and then this year. You are a top 3 100 player in League of Legends. We were talking off air. We think there's probably over 1 million League of Legends player, right? So that tells you how good Felix is. Felix, thanks for joining us. You got to be fired up about what is going on with League of Legends here at Purdue Northwest.
No, for sure. Justin's made this exceptional program, and then he keeps bringing on these wonderful players that continue to give back to us. So I'm super excited for my last season competing, and I can't wait to see where we go with this new team.
Congrats on the Battle for Indiana Championship. I mean, that to me is just amazing, beating Purdue and Ball State and IU.
It's very expected for us because I think I have us in very high regards. So, you know, just to calm it a little bit.
We are also joined by Ryan Soja, also from Munster, Indiana, also an accounting major. And Ryan plays Valorant, and you are a top player in Valorant. So how are you, a sophomore, how are you enjoying your experience?
It's awesome. It's a lot like the high school experience. Take it to the next level.
Excellent. That's great. So, guys, take us back in your journey. Tell us, Felix, how did you get started in esports?
So, I really got started when back in high school, Mr. Thompson, when he still worked at Munster, he made a program available to all of us to be able to compete. And back then there was a program called HSCL where we would play often. So I used to play in both Rocket League and League of Legends. Eventually, once I entered into the collegiate space, I stayed with just League of Legends when I realized that I didn't have enough time for both. So here we are.
Ryan, how did you get started in esports?
I also played at Munster in my high school, but it was under a new director.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how I started.
Guys, tell me about your love for esports. You know, I go by the esports arena on campus. It's jam-packed with students. You guys spend all kinds of time. Felix, tell me about your love of this sport.
So one of the things about this sport is, since it is online, you have so much potential to just play from everywhere. Every single time, you can just have the same experience, whether you're in California, New Mexico, to all the way in Maine. You're going to have the same experience playing against the same players. So at the end of the day, it really becomes a battle of how much do you really want to improve and how much do you want to push yourself. And it's that drive that will keep you going and going. And, yeah, that's what I really love.
Ryan, tell us about what you like about esports.
I really enjoy the hype my team brings while also being able to compete online and play a video game for fun.
Great. Coach, what do these gentlemen mean to our program?
I mean, they mean everything. Felix was the pioneer getting us started with the League of Legends team. And then it's kind of the same thing for Ryan. You know, the Valorant team was a couple years after the League of Legends team, but he was the first kids that we ended up recruiting to be able to get the team that we have today. So we wouldn't be here today without either of them.
Felix, what drew you to Purdue Northwest?
Sorry?
What drew you to come to enroll at Purdue Northwest? And
so I love the education. Initially, I planned on either coming to PNW or IU. But made the split decision when esports was a program that was like a really big push for me because I really did want to compete in the space. So, yeah.
Ryan, why did you decide on Purdue Northwest?
I'm from Munster. It's a close 10-minute drive, and they also offered me esports.
Excellent. So, Felix, accounting major, I know you had an internship over the summer, and why don't you tell our listening audience about what you were up to?
Yeah, so I actually interned at KPMG downtown, KPMG LLP, and I really loved the experience, really loved everything that they showed us throughout the firm. I have an offer extended as an audit associate position, so I'm looking to start that in the summer of 24, and I cannot be more excited because I love that entire work experience, and I really love where accounting has taken me.
Well, that's great. You're going to find that's a very rewarding career. And maybe you can recruit the guy next year, right?
For sure.
All right. So we're going to see if we get to know you guys a little bit better, our rapid fire section. Felix, what's your favorite ice cream?
Definitely cookies and cream.
All right. Favorite food?
Pizza.
All right. What are you watching on Netflix?
Narcos recently. Catching up with a lot of that.
Okay. And are you on social media?
Yeah, on Twitter and Instagram. Underscore Felixburg underscore on Instagram, and I honestly forgot my Twitter handle, so.
All right, look at that. I appreciate that. Ryan, what's your favorite ice cream?
It's gotta be mint.
Food?
Chicken.
All right, Netflix?
Any romance.
Okay, and how about social media?
My name Ryan Soja, but two A's in Soja.
Okay, all right. Where do you guys think Coach Bragg is, what do you think his favorite ice cream is? See what, how well you know him.
I know, I'm pretty sure it's mint, right?
No.
No. He told me this a long time ago, but I remember I have arguments with him every single time that I know it's not cookies and cream. Because I've gone back and forth with him about this, but I completely forgot what his favorite flavor is.
Yeah, so it's Coach.
It's cookies and cream.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
So then do I have the argument with you or Samba?
It's probably Samba.
Okay.
What do you think his favorite food is?
Pizza, maybe. I'm thinking pizza or like pasta.
Do you have any guesses?
Chicken Alfredo from Olive Garden.
That is pretty good. My favorite's Mexican food, tacos.
Okay. All right. Is he on social media?
Honestly, I don't know.
I have a LinkedIn. I don't have. I try to just use a Twitter account for the school to go over the Twitter stuff.
All right. Coach, tell us again about the Fan Fest. Our listening audience, was Saturday, Sunday, Westville.
Yeah, so the event, doors will open at 9 a.m., starts at 10 a.m., and we'll go basically to all the tournaments being done. So we have a list of events on unified.gg, and we will have any game from Valorant to League of Legends to fighting games. There we'll even do a cosplay event where you can come and dress up as your favorite character from a game, and you'll get rated by a committee, and then whoever has the best costume will win the cosplay event. There's really anything and everything from as little as 8 years old all the way up to college students or even anyone at working age as well. It's a really fun event. It's a really cool thing for the community to do to get to know a little more about esports.
Tell our listening audience about the opportunities available for prospective student athletes from an esports perspective in your program.
So we obviously recruit players. So if you're a good player in any of our varsity titles, which would be League of Legends, Rocket League, Call of Duty, and Super Smash Brothers, we're recruiting. We give scholarships for all of those games. So if you reach out on our website or email me, we'll be able to help out with that. Outside of the games, we also recruit for game managers, social media managers, broadcasters, really any of the secondary help outside of the game that is needed to help run the esports program as well. So we recruit for all of that.
Excellent. Thank you, Coach. You guys are off to a great start this year. Great performance in the 66 games, battle for Indiana champs. You got the NACE playoffs going on. I can't wait to see where this goes this year. So congrats on all your success and really looking forward to a great season. That wraps up this edition of PNW Athletics Today. But before we go, let me thank our corporate champions, Purdue Federal Credit Union and Jeff Love. We appreciate all their support. Laborers Local 41, Scott Sparks, thanks for everything you do for the pride of Purdue Northwest. Pepsi, Rush Physical Therapy, MJ Polish Deli. Big thanks to Don Kitchell and the Kitchell Group at Morgan Stanley. Domino's Pizza provided our tailgate last Saturday or Sunday for the semifinals, and they'll be out there again this Sunday for the championship. Bridges Scoreboard, Fairfield Inn, Largus Graphics, Hampton Inn, and Holiday Inn. Right down the street is Kyle Dempsey State Farm. Appreciate all your support. Jed TV, we are very thankful for televising over 150 Purdue Northwest athletic contest, Crazy Kaplan Fireworks, Corellis Roofing, NWI 24/7 ER and Hospital. Shout out to Jessica Hubbard, who is really supporting the pride at Purdue Northwest. Rick Kalinske and Nipsco, thank you. Miller Pizza, LC Goldberg got great pizza. Montesol, McDonald's, Hudamaki, People's Bank, North Point Orthopedics, Strack Van Til, Spark Marketing are just some of the corporate champions. We also got to mention South Shore CVA and all of their support by David Uran and Megan Gooden. If you'd like to be a champion for PNW Athletics, give me a call, Rick Costello at 219-989-2540. All right, again, shout out to soccer this Sunday, championship game, Dowling Park, 1 o'clock, and go Pride!
Everything's well.